And somebody asked to appoint new people, whether it is young people or old people, which is better. Then I answered, it is a question of a person's maturity, physical health or robust health, and also his intention to serve the people. The qualities are neither the qualities of young or old. We have seen lot of people, old like Dr. N.S. Ramaswamy, who can do lot of these things. I have seen lot of people suffering with arthritis, nephritis, spondylitis, those who are young between 30 and 35. So, age is entirely different. If you say health, it is with both of the people, both the facility as well as the problem. Maturity is also like that. If a person crosses the age, psychologically he is dismantled. The person gets something with hysteria, oblivion and various other errors. It is common to old age. If you consider that the growing old will also improve the status of excellence and performance, that is also wrong. So, we need some people who is able, who is mature, who is mentally and physically healthy, those who have the craving to serve the society. Both models are wrong. Because they said that the youngsters will do something more and the old people, they will be very slow. So, to crawl like the old people, that model is also wrong. To jump like the young model, that is also wrong. We have to have a uniform, standard, stable and shrewd motion that is suitable for the time and for the problem, which may be between a crawl and jump. That is what we call the new model. So, on the basis of these things, somebody told how leaders will emerge. The Shastras, they give lot of philosophical backgrounds. One is natural emergence. Every time when there is a crisis, there will be emergence of leaders. That is natural emergence. Psychological emergence. When there is a pressure, that pressure will liberate lot of your chains and chambers so that lot of leadership qualities will be promoted and they will be integrated later. That is psychological. Sociological, when there is a pressure over the mass of the society, they will create something to create a leader from their own self and it will be automatically done. Ethical, when ethics is trampled, naturally the ethics will rise with more pressure. Philosophical, when there is adharma and dharma in proportion or something rules more than that, naturally it will come. That is philosophical solution. Religion, when there is any problem due to abnormity or irreligiosity or immorality which has taken its challenges upon the morale of the society, the code of conduct or principles of the society, then God descends or sends somebody. There is a religious model. So everywhere there is a hope for leadership, and we have also a connective, relative, distributive responsibility and liability in responding to the leadership, molding the leadership, watching the leadership. If it is over, we have to recycle the leadership. Because if there is a time gap, that's what I told, if there is Indian War of Independence, that is over. That small time gap has diluted the intense desire as well as patriotism of most of the people. They have been vexed and exhausted. So time gap, that automatically makes our tempo slow. If tempo is made slow, then immediately we result into a problem known as suction. What is the problem known as? Suction. The selected people will be diverted and the people, those who are selected, will be diluted. That is known as suction. They will go somewhere else. So it is what we are seeing and experiencing now. So these rules of emergence will come for rescue. What we are going to do in this seminar, what are the models of approach to society? I want to say a few models. One is the incentive model. For everything like domestic products and other multi-purpose utility products, they show some incentives. So to attract people and to give them benefit, you must see some incentive model. And second thing is connective benefit model, in which they must have some connective benefit apart from incentive, that must have a closer connectivity to their way of life. The third thing is a triple F model. What is triple F? Fashion, fascination and fabrication model. You have to design the same way in which I am saying, I am not having any fashion or fascination, so I am not suitable, I think. So somebody, the same thing should be represented in a different shape. And the same content should be represented in a different model. And the presentation should be something attractive, something sophisticated, ultra model. So content presentation and the methodological presentation, as well as the availability and resources under external and internal designs, they must be new. So fashioning is giving the knowledge in a very adaptable dose. And fascination is promoting it with people, those who are very common and attractive with the society. Fabrication is multimedia presentation, model presentation, then iconic presentation, various other attractive methods would be there. So we have to fashion the knowledge, fascinate with new people, and we have to fabricate the methodologies by means of some type of shopping, some type of multimedia technical presentation, I've already told. So who does it is known as fascination. Which is changed, that is known as fashion. How it is presented and given in your hand, that is known as fabrication. That must have a proper root. and proper proportion. It should not be more than a prescribed level due to which the content will be lost. In a sugar coated medicine, if the proportion of the drug and the sugar base, if it is ulta, that is if it is reverse, what will be the effect of the drug? Likewise, there must be a recent methodology of governing the proportion between these things. It is known as triple F model. Fourth thing is self-attunement model. First model is self-attunement. You behave like that, be like that, so that you can inspire at least your proximate people and neighbors. That is self-attunement model. And the fifth thing is feasible access model. You cannot change the world or Iran or Russia or Armenia. You change the people, those who are surrendering to you or believers of you or dependents on you. That is feasible access model. Then targeted concentration model, you target on kids, target on youngsters, target on students, target on downtrodden people, target on people, those who are about to be converted into antisocial elements as a preventive methodology. So it is known as targeted concentration, where either they will become imbecile or they will become aggressive. There, as a preventive measure, we have to target them. It is known as targeted concentration model. Apart from that, there is one wisdom vigilance model, which is only for the learned people. That is specially for learned people with analytical tabulations, categorizations, and various other prima facie view solutions. It is a technical and logistic way of approach of the problems. Vigilance and wisdom model. Then wider and deeper access model. Deeper access model is training them under Gurukula system. Wider access model is media presentation. If it mixes in media with some brand ambassadors, just as they are having for UN and other things, by that we can have a wider access as well as the deeper access. These things are the various models. But we must start about something. What is immediate, mediate, and ultimate? We have to classify. And also brief, wide, wider, widest. Immediately we cannot think about Russia or Japan or something else. Global thinking is good, but local operation is preferable, safe, and infallible. So we have to start with that. And if you want to do something at Pakistan or Afghanistan, what we can do apart from praying for them, what we can do in Georgia and Cuba, what we can do? There are some models. One is combined political decisions. If there is combined political decision, we can do. Second is a federal network. If we have federal network everywhere, we can do. Third thing is very interesting. It is known as axe log model. What is axe log? The log of an axe is made out of the same wood. If we have the same persons or same group of persons who belong to the same group of the sensational elements of the society, if we have supporters also from the same side, through them we can act or activate. That is known as axe log model. So by means of these special approaches, we can approach lot of other people. So these various models, we have to think that each and every person presented here, we have to write descriptively, illustratively about all of these things. Now asking from you, what is the time that you can dedicate? Monthly or weekly, 1 hour, 2 hours, what is the time? What is the resources? Money resources or writing or lecture or whatever it is. Third thing, how you can be present, how much you can be present. Fourth thing is active participation, how long you can take, how much you can take. Fifth is influence. Even if you can do, along with yours, there are a lot of other connective networks, how you can create a way for extending and expanding the network. So time, resources, active presentation, your presence and influence, that we have to tabulate how much we can do. For example, I can attend 5 lectures, I can give 1 lakh per month, and like that we can design something, either money or matter or mind or might or courage, whatever it may be, any resource we can design. Now coming to the concluding session, we are talking about Indic leadership. What is Indic leadership and what do you mean by India? There are 4 Indias. Which India you call? Is it real India or surreal India, ideal India or ideal India? Which India do you mention? There are a lot of people in poverty, illiteracy, in fact mortality rate is more and malnutrition is more than thousands of villagers is suffering from malnutrition. This is the real India. And we are seeing promotion of lot of IT industries, SEZs, and lot of foreign embassies are there, MNCs are establishing here, multi-storied buildings. These things are known as surreal India.